Going out to sea is one of the greatest things about my job, and I've been lucky enough to be able to do it on a consistent basis because it is something that I really love. My specialty is in the deep sea and deep sea ecosystems, exploring new parts of the world's oceans that no one has ever seen before. A lot of my work in recent years is focused around the Deepwater Horizon oil spill in the Gulf of Mexico. I've been working in the Gulf of Mexico for about 15 years. My collaborators and I were some of the only ones who had baseline data before the oil spill, and so we were called upon pretty quickly to go back down there and see what sort of impact it had in the deep ocean. Our impact in the deep sea is increasing. Oil drilling's not slowing down in deep water, and this is laying the groundwork for what our response would be to another oil spill in the future. I have an NSF-funded study that's looking at something slightly different. It's looking at ocean acidification in the deep sea. So as we dump CO2 into the atmosphere, it finds its way into the ocean and it makes the oceans more acidic. And that makes it very difficult for deep water corals to lay down their skeletons and to continue to grow. We go out on a very large ship, usually well over 200 feet. And in some occasions, I've been lucky enough to go down myself and visit in a manned submersible. And it gives you a perspective that you can't really get any other way. Visiting a place like that in person is really a unique perspective. A lot of students and faculty from Temple come with me on these trips. We do a lot of genetic work, looking at gene flow among the corals and trying to tell them apart, tell the species apart by using genetic tools. But we also bring a lot of live corals back to the lab. One of the things we found in the ocean acidification work is that different corals respond to it very differently. And so when we can understand that, and we can understand the genetic and the physiological basis for those differences, we might be able to make some predictions for the future, and we might be able to find the method that'll help preserve corals as we continue to have this effect in the oceans. Deep sea corals have become a source of drugs from the sea. We found a lot of these remarkable and unique compounds that are created by deep sea corals that have pharmaceutical applications. I really think part of my job is opening up these experiences to the students at Temple and trying to bring them out there, show them what's possible, show them the wide variety of things you can study in biology, and to just get that field experience of being out there in the middle of the ocean and maybe even going down to the bottom of the sea.